get the night started with an all-new episode of Mario & Luigi Paper Jam.
I think it'll fail on special enemies. Like, if they're sparkle enemies, I think it'll fail. And if they're paper enemies, they might fail. And they'll definitely fail on bosses.
That's unfair. I should be able to turn a boss into a Goomba.
Just imagine turning Petey Piranha into a Goomba.
Just imagine endgame boss turn Bowser into a Goomba, one hit KO.
That would be great.
Now I need a syrup. Oh wait, no, I can use the BP one now. Yeah.
Say, we might want to use that BP card.
Yeah, down to one.
Let's see how... Oh, it restores all. That's nice.
Oh, crud. Well, that...
Gosh darn it, Scott!
Ugh!
That's the wrong numbers.
Oh, I still got the other two.
It still dealt the same damage. 26 on both.
Oh, I got the Goomba card!
Do it! Oh,
but it's still level 10. Oh, that sucks.
Level 10 paper Goombas are useless.
Jeez.
That makes me so happy. That was like the most satisfying thing I've seen.
Oh, jeez.
Turning Koopas into paper Goombas. Oh, it makes me happy. I'm about to say, you're missing Paper Mario.
Did I just hit him with Paper Mario?
Yep.
Oh, nice.
Because if you jump and the enemy hits, like, let's say Luigi lands on him, you'd be attacking Luigi.
Yeah. Alright, I guess.
It's like that mechanic in, Paper Mario, or A Thousand Year Door. If you use Koops to, like, his on-field ability thing, he'll attack an enemy if you throw him at an enemy.
That's true. Do I really need the HP card?
Kaboom!
See, part of the problem here is the fact that you can only have three cards at any given time, so you're trying to decide, well, do I want to keep these cards, or do I want to just flip them over so I can keep reshuffling the deck and getting the other cards?
I was about to say, if you flip them over, doesn't it recycle the deck?
Yeah, but I have to flip all of them over. So right now I've got the emergency block, the HP card, and the attack lowering one.
You can't just flip one over?
No, I have to flip all three in order to reshuffle.
That's dumb.
Which means I'm gonna lose all three.
So you can't just flip one over and it gets sent into the deck and then you draw one?
No.
Like on the next turn?
No, because the deck is empty right now. It's at zero. And the only way it reshuffles is once you've gone through all 10 cards in the set.
What the heck?
Just to make it that much harder.
That's dumb. Listen, I don't think we need to fight another cheat sheet, but okay.
Hey, it's giving me EXP, and if I can get up to the next rank, then I think we're going to be okay in the attack power department. Oh, jeez.
Well, we're out of BP, so I don't know what you plan on doing.
Well, yeah, that kind of sucks. Syrup jar. Mario's using all the BP attacks. Luigi and Paper Mario aren't really doing anything. Even though Paper Mario has the highest BP attacks of all three.
Does he?
Yeah, Trio Racket and Trio Kite use 6 and 8 points.
I thought Rocket used 6.
5.
Hmm.
It didn't knock- it didn't knock any of them out!
Okay, there wasn't any other option. It was only emergency block.
Yeah. And I lost 2 copies. God. Where's the ex- jinx.
Oh no, we're creased.
I'll use the herb. In fact, let me use this HP card because I'm taking some damage too. Flip this, flip that, so we can reshuffle. There we go. Copy.
Paste.
I thought it was supposed to be cut and paste.
I always do copy and paste.
What do you have against cutting? You don't like scissors?
I don't like cutting and I don't like scissors.
Okay. Enough said right there.
I don't think you're doing that much damage on that spike.
Oh, shoot. Defense down?
It doesn't matter. Rank you up. Oh, yes!
Alright. Okay, so to recap, we already have BP up on Mario. Options. Options are gear slot plus 1, star point max plus 10, gives you a pow up plus, gives you an extra 1 pow, and speed up plus gives you an extra 1 speed every time you level up, and stash up.
Let's go with that star power, because that affects everybody.
Increases your maximum star points by 10, only one bro can select this.
Well, the star points are shared across all characters, right?
Yep.
So yeah, it wouldn't matter who got it.
Alright, so, go with star points. Locked in.
Let's go!
I hate that- I'm kinda sad we don't have the roulette for our leveling up anymore.
Well, it's kind of sad, but I'm actually happy that they don't have it, because I remember in Dream Team, I kept having to redo the battle every time I leveled up, because I would go for the highest roulette option, which was usually a 5, and I would always end up getting like a 3, and have to reset the battle.
I mean, it's not really having to reset the battle. The roulette was up to luck.
Yeah.
There's a crack.
Where?
To the right, to the right, to the right, right there.
There we go.
Super candy.
Nice.
Maybe it'll restore our HP by more than a bit.
Well, I need to use a mushroom anyways, so... Jeez.
That wasn't the joke I was making.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Fighting out Roy and Wendy.
Yeah.
And we were looking at the candy and...
Oh, yeah.
stores HP by a bit.
What is a bit? I mean, is it percentage? Is it just 5?
I should look that up.
It says the super candy restores a decent amount. What is a decent amount?
Candy. Paper jam. Let's open this up again.
There we go.
Items and objects.
Oh, nice.
Candy can refer to any of the following.
What?
Candies. Items in Mario Party 8 that are similar to the capsules of previous Mario Party games.
Oh, we got a super nut!
Aw, yeah. Oh, they're okay. They're restoring health from Dream Team items.
Well, obviously.
I didn't know that came from Dream Team.
It doesn't specify how much.
It's... When one of them eats it, this is for Dream Team, I don't know about Paper Jam. But it says, they regain approximately 40% of their maximum heart points and bro points.
Great, why couldn't they just say that in the description of the item?
I have no clue. Let's see what Super Candies are for. Super Candies are consumable items in Mario & Luigi Dream Team and Mario & Luigi Paper Jam. They are in the shape of a star and can be used by Mario or Luigi. Not Paper Mario, just Mario or Luigi. When one of them eats it, they heal roughly 60% of their maximum heart points and burn points. And in Dream Team, several enemies and bosses can drop them. But that's about it.
Okay.
But now we know, regular candy is 40%, super candy is
60%. Oh! Yeah, that was funny.
What happened?
The Koopa Troopa attacked Paper Mario. I hit him with the hammer, and he came out of his shell, and then I hit his shell, and he went running after it.
Nice!
Oh, jeez.
I hate that I missed that.
Level up! Alright, so, Luigi already has the defense up. Remaining 4 options. Gear slot plus 1. POW up plus. Speed up plus. Stash up plus.
Let's give Luigi that speed.
An extra 1 speed every time you level up.
Do we want speed or stash? Luigi's already got a bunch of stash. So let's do speed.
Alright.
And then when Paper Mario levels up, we're giving him the gear slot.
Alright, speed up plus.
Let's go!
Plus 3 for stash, plus 4 for speed.
Yahoo!
What's down here? Oh. I think I'm gonna attack all of these guys. Just say forget it and focus on EXP. Oh, I can use the Goomba but if I use the Goomba, it doesn't stay shiny, does it?
I don't think it would.
Aw, darn it.
We already have enough shiny amiibo cards, though, so let's try it out.
Okay. Use that rationale for everything, right?
Yep, let's see what happens.
Oh.
One of them turned into a Goomba.
What a waste of 5 star points!
Well, now we know.
Jeez. Down to a 1 out of 30 star points here.
Oh my goodness.
I guess I won't be using battle cards for a while.
Or don't we get them for every successful, bros move and trio move thing?
Yeah, well, I'm up to 2 now. Oh, now I'm up to 3. Goomba, level 11. Jeez.
I want to get to, like, really far in the game, and we still have that card, and we use it, and it's like, we have, there's this, like, really tough level 20 enemy or something, and we use that card, and we turn him into a level 20 Goomba.
What was you and your obsession with Goombas?
It's not an obsession, it's more that it's just funny to me. Just the fact that that card exists is funny to me. Yeah. Wham!
Bam!
Direct hit!
Oh no, it's gonna blow up again. Oh jeez. Watch how much damage I'm taking, okay?
Enough to make Paper Mario lose 3, copies.
And that's with the emergency block, if you please.
I don't think it would matter for Paper Mario, but I think Mario was taking, like...
Mario lost, like, 20 HP from that, because the explosion hit, like, 5 times.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's like, Mario took 4 damage every hit. Mario is now out of BP again. Didn't notice it said 5 before you used the rockets.
Yeah. I kind of glossed over that statistic.
Way to go. What's the expert rocket blast?
Five excellence in a row was the rocket blast attack.
Oh, neat.
Fireflower time. I feel like Mario could use a lot more BP.
Oh yeah, big time.
Because Mario's always running out of BP and the other two aren't. Level up.
And rank up.
So, Paper Mario already has HP up plus, remaining 3 options, Gear Slot, Pow Up, and Stash Up.
Gear Slot.
Gear Slot plus 1.
And now we can equip that Star Brooch onto Paper Mario.
Excellent. Let's do that. Right, so Paper Mario. Oh, so I guess they max out at 3 gear options per character?
I guess so. Which is weird, since it says you can only get one... or only one character can use that thing.
Well, not for the gear slot. For everything else, it's limited to one character, but the gear slot doesn't have that restriction.
Oh.
Conveniently. Well,
now I have to go back on what I said way earlier. Because remember, I thought that was the case with, everything, was that every upgrade was only limited to one character.
I don't know why they did that. I mean, if I want to give HP up to all 3, I should have the option. Because technically, if I did that, right, I'd be sacrificing one of the other stats at the same time. But...
yeah.
Alright, so grant star points whenever you land a lucky hit. So, somewhat situational, but see how that works.
Mm-hmm.
and the last enemy. Thank goodness. Let's use the damage card. I love how you can use a battle card and doesn't waste your character's turn.
Oh man, there are a bunch of glitches.
What kind of glitches?
Well, we've got out-of-bounds glitches, fast-forward storage, boss glitches, crashing glitches.
In Paper Jam?
Yeah. We've got text glitches, party graphical glitches, miscellaneous glitches.
Miscellaneous glitches.
Like, one of the party graphics, the only party graphics, is messed up Luigi graphics.
That was intentional, I swear it was.
If the player accesses... Oh wait, never mind, that's for a place that we're not at, that we're, not at yet.
They've had 3 years to work on this game. You would think that they could sort most of this stuff out.
Have they been working on this for 3 years?
Yeah, because Dream Team came out, it was summer... Wasn't it summer of 2013?
Well, I don't... Did they ever say that they immediately started working on this after Dream Team?
Not specifically, but what other games does AlphaDream work on? Or what have they worked on that's come out aside from Paper Jam?
I can find out.
This pipe is off limits for the time being because it connects to... Whoops, I almost slipped some top secret info. Good thing I caught myself. Please check again later.
Some top secret info.
This is the newest Lakitu Info Center in all of the Mushroom Kingdom. It's fresh out of the oven. Because of that, we're running a bit of a bare-bones operation for the time being. Be sure to check in later once we finish setting things up. I can tell you guys are just itching to rescue some paper toads. Are you itching?
Oh, no. No, I'm not even gonna be sarcastic with this one.
Rescue all the paper toads in the area. Tropical paper toad hunt. Here we go.
They made the Hamtaro game.
In the last 2 years?
Oh, I'm not looking at past 2 years. I'm just looking at all the software that they've done.
Oh. Cause I was gonna say,
but
what
like
else?
It's not a common practice for them to complete and shell out one game, and once that game is completed, they immediately rush into development for another one. So I don't think they've had 3 years to work on it.
Well, for instance, I mean, like, I can understand. Oh! I got the Koopa again with the hammer one.
I know that, the only instance I'm aware of people doing that is, the Zelda development team, when they made Ocarina of Time, and Ocarina of Time 3D, and then they went on record stating that they immediately started working on Majora's Mask, and it took them from Ocarina's launch to... What was it, 2015 when Majora's Mask came out?
You mean the 3D version?
Yeah, the 3D version. Yeah, it was 2015. Because it was in February. Because it came out the week that I was doing Shrek the Musical. Like, it came out the week of the play, and we, and I remember having my 3DS with me, because it was my Persona Q1, and I would just play it backstage in the dressing room, and I beat it a week after it came out. Because it was on Sunday that I beat it.
Well, for instance, I know Intelligent Systems goes back and forth between Fire Emblem and Paper Mario, and then a couple years back they were doing the Pushmo series. But recently, it seems like they've stepped away from Pushmo, and they're focusing solely on Fire Emblem. But I would assume that they alternate. So I was thinking maybe AlphaDream was like the same thing.
There's no clue. I really don't think this game has been in development for 3 years, though. It would be way more fleshed out if that were the case.
Look at all those bubbles.
My bubbles. There's a toad hiding in that crack.
Every time
you see... you can just stack up all three and have a better time at getting those, right?
Are you sure they won't just float higher?
I'm pretty sure they wouldn't.
Alright, let's try.
Well, you already got the thing, so it doesn't matter now.
Well, I mean, for the next one. Well, never mind.
There's a toad in the crack. Yes, toad.
Okay, I was too scared to leave my hiding spot.
Right, that was too funny.
Halfway there.
Hey, Scott.
Yes.
At least you're not timed.
Wow. Yeah.
So close. So close. So close.
Where? Am I on the right? There we go. It's hard to judge sometimes.
Let's go!
I want to look at this scratch twitches.
I probably should have given Mario the syrup jar before this battle started.
Yeah. Apparently there's a glitch that lets you skip any boss battle.
Really?
I'm gonna look that up. Well, I'm gonna look into it. Apparently there's also a Wacky 2 Info Center crash.
From what you're telling me, it's like I should save the game after every battle because something could glitch out.
Dude, there are so many freaking glitches. Like, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51 glitches.
Got him. That seems unusual for a Mario game.
Oh god. The Luigi 2 Info Center crash may corrupt your game save file.
Okay, so... feel free to share so I don't repeat what, causes that crash.
Okay, so... skipping missions in an area can knock the list out of order when the player tries to replay them in the Luigi 2 Info Center. If this is done, and then a hard mode version of the mission is selected, while the mission is occupying the wrong slot in the menu, then the game will crash. This is likely because the game thinks you're playing the mission in the original slot, and looks for a non-existent hard mode version to overwrite.
Okay.
Ooh, we're in Twinsy Tropics, right?
Yep.
Apparently there's a Japanese text and English game glitch that occurs in Twinsy Tropics.
How do people find out these glitches? I haven't run into a single glitch in so far, anyway.
I couldn't tell you, man. Apparently, if you exit Twinsy Tropics without the boat, then enter a Lakitu Info Center, you can play the Toad missions from Twinsy Tropics. Beating these displays a message in Japanese that there are no more paper toads in the current area, regardless of what region the game is set to. Apparently there are glitches that let you play at solely as Mario, Luigi, or Paper Mario.
Weird stuff.
So to skip any boss, you have to use an out-of-bounds glitch to escape a Toad mission, like the ones in Twinsy Tropics, then fight a boss or required enemy battle, die, then click to go back to the title screen. The game now thinks you've won the battle and moves on with the story.
Ah, jeez.
Huh!
Next one, Fly Guy Patrol.
You sure you don't want to give that one a try, Scott?
I don't know. I think that would be a little bit, too risky. Especially from what you're telling me from the other one that corrupts your save file.
I've only seen four that corrupt the save file, and that's Toad Storage, Gloomy Woods Early, Out of Bounds in Twinsy Tropics Dungeon, and then the Lakitu Info Center. Okay, apparently playing as Paper Mario will do the same thing.
Nice.
And wrong trio attack order.
This mission is very tedious.
What is it? Are you just having to hunt for... Oh, it's a stealth mission.
Yeah.
That's lame, dude. Go and nab him. I was gonna say, dude, what are you doing? You could just went around the rock when the shy guy went up.
Yeah, I was kind of distracted there. I was gonna say, don't you think it's a little bit odd that the shy guys are wearing binoculars that specifically only allow them to see line of sight?
Not what binoculars usually do.
I mean, they could open up their field of vision so much more if they just didn't use the binoculars.
Oh man, there's so many shy guys here. You're gonna have to dash to get that toad. Way to go. Why can't we just fight these shy guys?
I would love to, but then we would fail the mission. Oh, jeez.
Well, I mean, I don't see why we can't just beat up the shy guys.
Whoa, that was close.
That was close. You almost got caught, buddy.
It'd be so much easier if we could just take them all
just
out.
Just walk up behind them and bash them in the head with a hammer.
Actually, I can't use the hammer right now.
Oh, yeah, but it would be so much easier if you could.
Well, even if I wanted to, they've disabled the usage of the hammer. And they've disabled the grab usage as well.
It's not what I'm seeing, Scott.
Never mind.
I get that they disabled it. I mean, they could have made the mission a lot easier if they just let you bash them in the back of the head with a hammer.
Exactly. But that's not the point of the mission.
Well, the mission is dumb. Like, see that? You could easily get that toad if you could just walk up and bust him up with a hammer.
Yeah.
I'd say it's worth it since it's the last toad, and there's only two of them.
Yeah.
Go!
Got it. So now, we should be able to get on the boat.
Rad.
Get off this island. Good news! Now that you've rescued enough of us, Paper Toads, we can help make that boat!
You may not want to hear this.
What?
So apparently, it's possible that after defeating an enemy, the battle won't end and enemy reward boxes won't open, and the only way to exit this is to reset the game. That's a battle doesn't end glitch. Nothing triggers it. It's just that it's possible.
Fantastic. Wow, just look at all of us. With all this Paper Toad power, we'll get that boat built in no time.
Oh, how I wish I could fold into a boat.
I'm heading back to...
Let me build you a boat.
I'm heading back to the dock now to get started. Meet us there later, okay? I'm sure the boat will be ready by the time you guys show up.
The boat.
Alright, team. Let's get building.
You know, that thing I can't turn into. The boat that we're making for you.
Alright, let's head back there.
I'm never gonna stop chatting this game about that. That is the dumbest thing I have
out
seen.
Out of the way! Ah, go back!
Wow!
Infinite supply of cheap.
Show me Cortez. Show me Cortez. Anytime anything deals with Paper Mario and boats, I demand to see Cortez.
Well, Cortez isn't in this game, so...
He should be!
I'm gonna buy the 1-up card.
Okay. I was gonna say, why are we at the other thing again?
Because I've got, like, 2,500 coins to spend. Was the HP. What else? Let's go with increases EXP by 50%.
Huh. That's interesting.
Change set has been added. Now you can make up to 3 battle card sets.
Oh, that's cool.
Okay. Alright, so let's replace the 20% HP recovery with 30% HP recovery.
Alright. I'm starting to think we can get rid of that 20 damage and just stick with the 30, because really we're dealing 30 damage to every enemy.
Yeah, good.
And that's...
But the 31 only applies to paper monsters.
Really?
It's all paper monsters with 30 damage. And
No. I mean, the one that hits all enemies for 10 points of damage 3 times.
Oh,
That's dealing 30 damage to each enemy.
Yeah, you're saying get rid of the 20 damage one.
Yeah.
Alright. And you want me to replace that with the life shroom?
Yeah.
There we go.
Assuming what I know about that card is correct, it's like, attack every enemy 3 times for 10 damage each.
I wonder why it wouldn't just say 30, unless it's taking the enemy's defense into account, or... Well, no, because it's a specific amount of damage.
Yeah.
So why would multiple times make a difference as opposed to just one time?
I guess it's the multiple enemies? I have no clue.
We finished the boat! It's our best work yet! It rides like a dream, too! Well, climb aboard and make yourself at home!
That is one...
We're so relieved! There's finally a way off this island! What's that? You want to know if we'll be riding with you in the boat?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, we found a different method of transportation. Yep, we'll handle taking the paper toads to Peach's castle. Don't worry about a thing.
Oh, how I wish I could fold into a boat.
We had the good luck of bumping into a Lakitu while we were building the boat.
Hey, let's build you a boat.
And since
now we don't need to turn into a boat. The Lakitu will help us get home.
Jeez. And we figured that since we're headed to Peach's castle anyway, we'd give the paper toads a lift.
Oh yeah.
Thanks for your help, guys. Good luck out there.
That was the most pointless thing.
Oh, that was half an hour wasted. Well then, let's head out.
Really, man? Luigi, what are you doing?
What's that? We have some additional passengers.
Oh, yeah.
We do? Luigi.
Oh, gotcha.
Okay. I was about to say, Luigi. He may not be able to turn into a boat anymore, but he could sure turn into a sail.
Mario! Wait for me! Too late. Come back next year.
Did I ever tell you that time when I was playing Heart Gold and I was using Action Replay on it and I actually managed to get stuck on the boat between
Well, that's because you're using an Action Replay, wasn't it?
No, like I wasn't stuck in the wall or anything. I was stuck on the boat, and the boat wouldn't ever dock. It wouldn't land in Vermilion, and it wouldn't land, in that other place.
Nice.
I can't remember the name of it.
Look at that blue sky. Smell that delicious green grass. Mwah! It's exactly like I remember. Wait a sec. I don't remember that part. Exactly, things are crazy. You guys should check on Peach's castle and make sure everything's okay. We're gonna rest here for a bit, but we'll head over there soon.
Does that mean we have to go back to Peach's castle?
Apparently. There's a lot of backtracking in this game.
It makes me mad.
Let's, go back, I suppose.
Wow. There's a question block I was wondering why you're just standing there.
I was trying to get the jump command back. Oh, oh.
Let's not fight these Monty. Gosh, darn
I'll fight one. It's a Monty Mole. Your favorite enemy of all time.
That's what I was just saying.
Level 12. I love how we're always the same level as these enemies. I mean, what kind of a coincidence is that?
Usually we're like one level lower.
Oh wow, if you want to look at it that way.
I am not wrong. Why are you jumping on it? Why not play whack-a-mole?
Well... I feel like I want to hit whacka with a hammer and get a whacka bump. Whoa! Oh. Hey! What?!
See, that's what you get for attacking a Monty Mole.
That's it. Now it is just... It's on.
Where does Mario keep that rocking?
I don't know. You're getting whacked.
Whack!
And still not enough to knock it out. There we go. Okay, let's run around like crazy and,
avoid the Monty Moles and get back to Peach's castle?
Yes. Oh, question mark. 50!
Ooh.
Am I missing anything?
Thank you, good.
A sign.
Two question blocks.
Oh, this way to Peach's castle.
Kinda figured that.
Knockout boots. What's that? Let's see. Increase your striking power with every enemy you defeat in a battle.
Look at that pow!
Ouch. So Mario would go up to 80, and Luigi would go up to 73.
Let's give them to Mario.
Right. Okay, let's go. It's a good thing they made it so you can jump with all three, with just X, because it was starting to get really annoying holding A, B, and Y together.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Your favorite guy's back.
Whacker?
Oh! Lock.
Super candy.
Go.
We got a super candy, Scott!
How super is it?
It's super...
There's nothing in here!
This area... That area at the top looks familiar. It's a Lakitu.
Oh, you again.
Well, that's rude.
We chatted a while back, remember?
It's like, oh!
It was outside Peach's castle way back when. Well, that was then, and this is now, so let's talk about current events. Mysterious pipe in the Lakitu Info Center is now open!
Okay...
The pipe will take you to the most amazing arcade ever! Take a break from saving the world and play some games! You deserve it!
Oh yeah!
This is extortion.
Should we go in the arcade or not?
No.
Oh, it's a Bob-omb.
We have... Oh, I think there's a Bob-omb glitch.
You want me to attack the Bob-omb?
I want to find out if... There's a bomb derby skip. that's not it. I guess there's not a Bob-omb glitch. Nah, just skip them.
Skipped. Oh, a star brooch.
A star brooch.
Too bad we don't have a gear slot on Mario or Luigi.
Oh well.
Ah, hey, this way to Peach's castle.
Glad to know. I kind of figured that was gonna be the case, but I'm glad to know.
$50 coins.
Aw, yeah.
Aw, what's with all the Monty walls? It's an infestation, I'm telling you.
For real, though.
Oh no, don't throw a rock at me while I'm doing this.
Wow, wow, wow. Mario!
Boy, am I glad to see you. You see, Princess Peach has...
Don't say it.
Actually, it'll be much easier if you just get to her castle and see for yourself. But what if I don't want to go to the castle? What if I want to go this way?
I hope so.
Aww.
I figured something like that was gonna be the case.
Gosh darn it.
I really figured something like that was gonna happen. Hey, there's a crack! There's a crack!
Wait,
there's
where? Crack. Oh, that's unique. Wait, is there
another? It looks like there's another crack.
How can he jump so high?
Cause he's Paper Mario, dude.
If he can jump that high, then why can I only jump this high?
Because you're not in a fight, and you're not in a place that needs you to jump that high in order to collect things. Hey look, it's Goombers! Yeah, it's a bunch of Goombers.
You and your Goomba card.
You like Goombers, right, Scott?
Maybe. Maybe not.
You trying to say you don't like Goombers?
No. Oh, it's awful. Just awful. What are we going to do? What are we going to do?
Don't say it.
Get a grip on yourself. My friend here is too distraught to speak clearly, so let me explain the situation. Please listen carefully. None of this fast-forwarding business, okay?
Oh, screw you!
There I was, taking my daily constitutional up Mount Brrr. When suddenly, who should appear but Bowser Jr. and Paper Bowser Jr., with both princesses in tow.
Oh, no.
Which means that the princesses aren't at Bowser's castle anymore. They're at Mount Brrr.
No way. Really?
Who knew that Pops had a villa way up here?
I never would have guessed.
Talk about a killer view. Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy. You want to buy some
Did you check out that awesome paper craft downstairs? It looks just like us. No way, this I gotta see. Where are we? On top of a mountain?
No! No! God.
Brr, I'm freezing!
These people are making me so mad.
At least we've got each other to stay warm.
Oh yeah, just cuddle up to a paper...
Ah, so you run cold too? Oh, how silly of me. Of course you do. After all, you are me.
Oh my god.
I wonder where Mario is. And of course, Paper Mario and Luigi. If your Mario is anything like the Mario from my world, I'm sure they're both fine.
I swear to god, if they say something about Luigi, I'm gonna just win.
They are very capable, aren't they? And so caring, especially toward Luigi, who, let's face it, is Luigi.
I saw it coming.
Well, Luigi tries his best, but he
I saw it coming, Sky.
Oh, jeez.
Hate these people.
You know, I never noticed how lovely our hair looks against our pink dresses. The pink really seems to bring out the golden undertones, don't you think? You're absolutely right.
I want to cut that paper peach off.
I don't blame Bowser.
To be honest, though, I've always wanted to do something really drastic to my hair. Like, chop it all off.
Do it!
Me too, but someone always talks me out of it. Oh, do they say that short hair isn't sufficiently princessy? I've heard that one a lot. Exactly, it's completely ridiculous.
Save it.
I do get tired.
Save it all off.
I do get tired of this look. Do you have any ideas about how to style it differently?
Oh my god.
Well, there's always a ponytail. It's good for playing sports, but it's hardly a new look.
Really?
I guess I could always try flat ironing it, or crimping it, or dyeing it purple.
Oh my god. I really felt like pulling a, Peter Griffin from Family Guy. I think it was Peter, when he's, in the car, and I think he's with Meg. Or he might have been with Joe and Quagmire, and they just roll by. Oh, it was the episode when Meg accidentally got together with Chris in that Halloween party. And Peter, and I think it was Quagmire, roll by, and Peter just shouts out, "Ugly!"
Those are all interesting options, but have you considered changing your outfit instead? Well, this is one of my favorite dresses. And like I mentioned, the pink goes so well with our hair color.
Oh my
god.
But
I've always been curious about how maroon would look on me.
Play Smash Brothers and find out.
Yes, variety is the spice of life.
Oh my god.
Once we get out of here, let's have a fashion show to debut our new looks. Ooh, excellent idea. I have a closet full of tiaras that I've never even worn.
Why?
Me too.
Oh my god.
Why are they
liking the
So, back to the castle. So the princesses aren't being held at Bowser's castle anymore. That's right. They're now at Bowser's villa way up at the top of Mount Brrr. Can you believe that creep has a villa? Bowser's treachery is even greater than we previously imagined.
I'm still livid about that Luigi comment.
I can just picture the sword scene now. The two princesses, distraught with fear, shivering in the cold.
Totally.
Frozen tears like ice drops on their faces.
That's exactly what's going on.
Well, the bratty Bowser Jr.'s whine endlessly about feeling bored.
I'll give him that one.
A fate worse than death.
This is a fate worse than death.
This cannot stand. That hateful Bowser. The only ones who can save the princesses now are...
If he makes a crack about Luigi.
Hey, where'd you guys go?
Please tell me they left. Thank God they left.
Our course is clear. Let's head to Mount Brrr. To get to Mount Brrr cuts through the north part of gloomy woods. You must hurry. The fate of the worlds is in your hands. Not to mention the princesses.
Can somebody shut that turtle up?
Right. Anyway, you're gonna need a paper craft, which I will take care of. You guys go ahead to Mount Brrr, and I'll meet you there.
Thanks, Turtle.
No worries, Green Dude.
Green Dude?!
I've been on all sorts of adventures recently, so I'm actually kind of an expert on this. See you at Mount Brrr. Fear not, beloved princess. This toad will never abandon you. Oh right, I almost forgot. I heard that the shops in Peach's castle have new inventory. We should check them out. Let's check out the shops.
The amount of Luigi hate in this game is too much, and it's making me angry.
Alright, let's see what we've got.
They're treating Luigi like he's that weird, nerdy kid from school, and it's making me very mad, and I want to hurt some of them.
Well, you're not supposed to hit the princess, so I don't know how you're supposed to hurt her.
I will take Luigi's Iron Ball Hammer, and I will crush them with Luigi's Iron Ball Hammer.
Alright, so let's give Luigi these super boots. Alright. Oh, a super hammer. That's gotta be better than the Iron Ball Hammer, which never drops the Iron Ball.
Yeah.
And, this is a conundrum, because the Super Hammer has higher attack, but the Fighter Hammer might force the enemies to skip a turn.
Hasn't forced them to skip a turn yet.
Alright, so we're going with the Super Hammer then.
I'd say its RNG is about as bad as the Iron Ball Hammer.
Okay, Super Wear. I don't want to lose 5 speed on Luigi.
Yeah, let's just keep that as is.
Okay, we've got Charge Gloves, Card HP Gloves, HP Scarf, BP Scarf, Stash Scarf.
We're losing so much defense and speed with those, though.
Okay, Paper Mario has everything it looks like, and yeah, that's it. Okay, let's sell this stuff.
I demand an explanation on all this Luigi hate.
There's just no love towards Luigi.
There's not, and that makes me mad, and I really want to smash them with a hammer.
We're keeping the other Star Brooch, right?
Yeah.
I still want to call it a brooch.
Bar Brooch.
Let's see what's in the item shop. Super Mushroom is new. Super Syrup Jar is new. And Super Nut!
But we already have so many Super Mushrooms and Super Jars.
Yeah. We've got 5 Super Syrup Jars and 13 Super Mushrooms.
Good God. How much does the Super Nut recover?
This, 30. And we've got 1!
We could go for some Super Nuts.
Refreshing Herb is also new, and the Boo Biscuit.
The Boo Biscuit?
Yes.
What the heck? Grants damage immunity, helps with dodge training. You think you need it, Scott?
Well, it's only 5 coins, but I think I can do without it.
Okay.
I'll buy some Super Nuts. Let's buy 5 of them.
Alright, that seems fine.
And I don't think there are any new battle cards, but not that we can afford them anyway, but let me check. Nothing new. Though I think the one that maxes out Paper Mario's copies might be useful in the future. And there we go! We're fully stocked up, and that's also all the time we have for you guys tonight. So, if you have any questions or comments, let us know. Make sure to follow us on all social media at TOONDISE and hashtag MLPaperJam. Until next time, I'm Scott, and I'll see you later!
Give Luigi some love, you guys.